It seems that both Patek Philippe and F.P. Journe are gone mad. Whilst the F.P. Journe Elegante has become quite the glorified electrician, the Patek put it Nautilus to some electroshocks. Believe it or not, inside these watches that cost tens of thousands of dollars is an electronic circuit powered by a battery, that same technology that powers a cheap Casio watch. So I ask again, are they gone mad? So let's start with the Patek Philippe. The Aquanaut Travel Time has been a grail watch for the enthusiast since its introduction, and thanks to the timeless sporty looks and the utility of the home time and the day-night indicator, this has become one of the best Patek Philippe watches out there. But this recent model, the 5269R, is packed with a solid 18K rose gold case in a compact 39mm case size. I bet you did notice the gorgeous dial is matching the rubber strap color. Thanks to the quartz movement, it measures just under 9mm thickness. You lose almost 2mm compared with the mechanical Aquanaut, but this alone justifies the $35,000 price. What you get for that money? Sure, it's a Patek, but it's a quartz one. If you can swallow that, then the watch is for you, minding you have that money to spare. Being a Patek, you expect to be flawless from any point of view. Well, it is not, because despite having a screw-down crown, water resistance is limited to only 30 meters, which is a shame for a watch that contained the word Aqua in its name. The dial is classic Aquanaut, and the globe-like embossed lines that recall longitude and latitude makes it seem like a sporty watch. In reality, it doesn't deliver that go-anywhere durability. The hands and applied Arabic numerals are crafted from the same rose gold as the case. This is a nice detail, worthy of a Patek Philippe watch. Need to mention the home text at the 6 o'clock position and the small aperture beneath it, that serves as a day-night indicator for the home time indicated by the additional white hour hand. Unlike every other travel time watch offered by the brand, all adjustments are done via the crown. In addition, this is one of the cleaner travel time dials offered by Patek Philippe, most of which are cluttered with other indicators and small displays. Being a quartz watch, we need to speak about its caliber, E23-250. Patek Philippe doesn't mess around here. As is plain to see, you can barely tell this is a quartz. That is, has gold engraved text, as expected, no plastic parts. The 96 component movement has 9 jewels and a 3-year battery life. Now, being a Patek, it is expected to be the best in any aspect, including in accuracy. Despite the beautiful caliber, it is a letdown when comparing the accuracy against the Grand Seiko quartz, for example. Accuracy is quoted at plus 127 to minus 18 seconds per year, which is great, but it's a little disappointing compared with Grand Seiko. The conclusion about this watch is that there is no doubt that some of you will reject it, because it's a quartz model and not a mechanical Aquanaut travel time. But I don't think the appeal here can be denied, a compact, simple, luxurious travel watch with the indisputable accuracy of quartz and the high-end craftsmanship we expect from Patek Philippe. If anything, I would have preferred the display case back, because this quartz caliber deserves that. If you don't have $35,000 to spend on the Patek Philippe Aquanaut in quartz, maybe you have $15,000 to buy the F.P. Journe Elegante. F.P. Journe watches must be all about mechanical mastery, right? I believe you all agree with me. The perfection of mechanical mastery is an art that goes back centuries. But it seems that is not the case here. But yet again, at around $15,000, it should be. The name on the dial alone should be enough. But I am still wondering why this could be a bad thing, since the vast majority of wristwatches in the world today are powered by a quartz caliber. Well, here's the thing, quartz and mechanical have a little bit of bad blood between them. It is all started in 1960s with the rivalry between the Swiss and the Japanese to build the most accurate watch in the world. But whilst each nation in public competed with traditional mechanical watches, each one was working in secret on something very different, the quartz caliber. Long story short, the Japanese applied such a mighty blow that it decimated the entire Swiss industry almost overnight. This was known as the quartz crisis, and a link is in the description below. Suffice to say that the watch from F.P. Jorn, despite being quartz, is a technological marvel. What Mr. Jorn has done with the Elegante is to introduce what is effectively a snooze function. There is a motion sensor built in. If the watch remains still for more than half an hour, the rotor doesn't rotate and the watch goes to sleep, and the hands stop moving. For daily use, that extends the life of the battery to 8 years. In rotation as part of a collection, up to 18 years. There's no competition here because pretty much any watch will have already gone in for service by that point. So you see, this is only one, but a very good example of why quartz watches deserve more recognition. It is very strange to see such a high-end hand-finish approach to making a quartz watch, and there's even a little surprise thrown in. For when the lights go out, the dial is fully luminous. Perhaps Mr. Jorn has a sense of humor after all. If you still didn't get it, then let me tell you why a man who spends his time making watches worth tens of thousands of dollars might dedicate his time to quartz calibers. Here is my answer. The mechanical wristwatch is not the full story. This journey is shared with clocks and pocket watches and quartz watches as well. Mr. Jorn has dedicated his life to master all those things.